DoorDash, the pioneer in food delivery. Living in a modern and fast-paced world, we all have limited time in our hands, making us turn to easy ways to grab something to eat. Here comes the role of food delivery services that offer convenience and accessibility to its customers, the very reason why they have been in demand for quite some time now. In 2013, Stanford University College students Evan Charles Moore, Andy Fang, Tony Xu, and Stanley Tang teamed up to establish the food courier company, DoorDash. Little did they know that their simple goal to enable every merchant to deliver and their simple idea to bring food right to people's doorsteps would change not only their lives, but the lives of the people in their community and also the course of the U.S. market. Using their innovative logistics, cutting-edge technology, and competitive marketing strategies, DoorDash conquered a steep climb to be one of the top three most extensive food delivery services in the U.S., worth several billions in 2020. The startup in Palo Alto has expanded in 56 markets and more than 600 cities across North America and invaded Canada and Australia. If you're craving some food, but you got a hectic schedule and did not have the energy to dine in, don't fret, because DoorDash has got you covered. You can order the food that you like from your favorite local restaurants through their application and have it delivered at your chosen time and place. Before DoorDash, there was Grubhub, which acted as a food ordering platform in major cities. But unlike Grubhub, DoorDash acts as a third-party food delivery platform, which handles the logistics of technology-driven delivery for restaurants. The kind of company that bridges customers to their favorite restaurants, empowers small businesses, and gives locals network opportunities. Grubhub had an interesting stronghold on the restaurant business, but with the rise of on-demand delivery, they would soon fall behind in the delivery wars. As the side hustle gig was ramping up dashers or delivery drivers and ensuring that they can work on flexible hours and have financial stability once they sign up. To enhance the application that they were developing in 2012, the founders of DoorDash spent some time interviewing a macaroon store manager to understand the needs and the problems of small business owners in Palo Alto City. Just as their talk was about to end, the manager shared her struggle with her piled-up delivery orders, and that might be the turning point of it all. Digging further into the issue, they found out from 200 other business owners in the Bay Area that most of them have the same problem, the lack of delivery service. Seeing that this had been a headache to small entrepreneurs in the city, the founders decided to develop a solution. They put their coding powers to fair use and gave birth to a landing page called paloaltodelivery.com. where they use their phone number as a contact. Despite not being confident with their prototype project, which Tony, the CEO, described as simple, ugly, they tried to shoot their shot to know if it is worth pursuing. Fortunately, they received their first call and order on January 12, 2013, which marked the start of them making deliveries around the Stanford campus. In June of the same year, they changed the name Palo Alto Delivery to DoorDash. Despite their hectic schedule as university students, the four were very hands-on with the dorm project. They opted to run everything by themselves. They were the ones making phone calls, receiving orders, picking them up, and bringing them to customers. Their valuable and enjoyable experience as delivery drivers pushed them to instill a culture in the company. They required every employee to start as a Dasher, delivering food on their first week. But it later changed to having their team members experience being delivery drivers once a month. A year after DoorDash was born, the group felt the need to change its image as it rose to prominence and grew more significant in size. With their stature, they negotiated and formed partnerships with different personalities and businesses. Setting their rebranding into motion, they decided to redesign the logo to make a strong first impression to their customers. They knew that logo is a crucial point in a business as it represents what their brand stands for. If you thought that designing is an easy feat, you are entirely wrong. as coming up with a new symbol proved to be a challenging process for the company. The design team had to reach out to DoorDash's stakeholders, the consumers, restaurants, and Dashers in their journey to find the right design that would accurately reflect the brand's ethics, values, and style. They took inspiration from Shinkansen, or the Japanese bullet train. One thing that DoorDash shares the same characteristics with, it is fast, efficient, communal, and revolutionary. It screams all the personality of the brand. As a result, they chose a minimalist and sleek logo that features two horizontal lines that signify speed, precision, and movement. Even though they did not expect anything when they first launched the fleet service, they racked up investors in their first year. They raised $120,000 from Y Combinator in the first round of funding and $2.4 million in the second round from seven other backers, enabling them to expand to 70 restaurants in the Bay Area. In the third round in May 2014, they gathered $17.3 million from Sequoia Capital, resulting in the company valued at a whopping $73.5 million. The idea of a food delivery might be a common thing in big cities, but they welcomed this new kid with arms wide open for the people of Palo Alto. It was evident because in just 15 months, over 1 in 6 households in the Bay Area Peninsula have used DoorDash, growing at a rate of 20% every week based on Y Combinator. DoorDash was then valued at a hefty $600 million in March 2015. By this time, a number of competing companies, such as Postmates and Uber Eats, had entered the market a year ago. There is actually low loyalty between using one app over the other among customers, so gaining a competitive advantage can be tough. Though many will see this tactic as controversial, one of DoorDash's strategies showed what the company was willing to do to beat the competition. In 2015, there was a string of complaints from customers getting food that was cold or not to their liking due to making uninformed decisions to a number of restaurants. Perplexed, many restaurant owners began finding out that the delivery company had been posting their restaurant menu on their app without their permission and just ordering by phone on behalf of the customer. This caused a rift between the restaurant businesses and customers in that they could not give them proper directions about portion sizes or more information about what they were ordering. Restaurant owners were furious with DoorDash's practice, especially In-N-Out Burger, as they filed a lawsuit against DoorDash. But the practice was also being used by other delivery companies as well, such as Grubhub and Postmates. DoorDash maintains they had no ill intent in hurting businesses and want to continue to provide the value that they do to customers and merchant partners. The state of California passed a law requiring delivery companies to have written agreements before adding the restaurants to their marketplace. Though controversial, sometimes in entrepreneurial pursuit, it is important to find out the value of an approach by just doing it first and finding out the outcome later. Chipotle initially objected to having their food delivered through this method, but in later years came around. While they were working to enter new markets outside the US, the team launched its app on Android to give the users a chance to have a one-of-a-kind DoorDash experience and continue to refine its branding. In 2016, however, the company experienced intense storms as it posed a lower share price, forcing them to conduct downfunding to survive. At the end of the year, they raised $125 million, which increased the brand's net value to $700 million, slightly lower than the projected $1 billion. Despite this outcome, it was still a good run for the group as they managed to stay afloat amid the tough competition without using false advertising and compromising their employees. In September the following year, they hit a milestone when they made their first acquisition with Rickshaw, a logistics startup offering same-day local delivery service. With this, the small business was dissolved to join the DoorDash team. Putting their customers at the top of their priorities, the company always thinks of ways to improve their service. They partnered with iMessage in November 2016 to introduce a group ordering feature, which they also offered through their website. In September 2017, they brought this feature to their iOS and Android apps for more convenience after less than a year. When DoorDash faced challenges back in 2016, many expected them to suffer the same fate as the small startups that failed and eventually died. But in a playful twist of fate, DoorDash lives to become one of the last men standing in the food delivery business field. So how did they do that? The answer might be simple, in that they are technology-driven, informed, consistent, and always open to new possibilities. Plus, they have a clean and straightforward interface that is pleasing to the eyes. Being knowledgeable about your chosen market and target audience is rewarding for your business. This is DoorDash's secret on why they are continuously reaping success. They were able to identify the places where people had fewer choices for food delivery service for low competition. Finding that their rivals had camped in the inner cities, they moved to focus on the suburbs, where they could be more useful and where the opportunity to grow is high. After branching out in many cities in the US, DoorDash decided that it's time to take their expertise and service internationally, specifically in Canada and Australia, where suburbs' needs are often neglected. The company has also introduced a DashPass subscription that allowed users to save money by giving them unlimited access to restaurants in their area. They have also partnered with Chase to offer this deal free for credit card holders. DoorDash has always been committed to delivering restaurant meals to people's doors. But this is not just their dream. They have a higher aim: to go beyond food and offer other products to transport. They have recently announced that they have partnered with CVS and their pharmacy to deliver groceries, food, non-food, and non-prescribed products. The logistics company has also started offering same-day delivery from 7-Eleven and Circle K. We can say that the founders of DoorDash are risk-takers and are never complicit with how they run their business. With that kind of mindset, they are on track with their ultimate goal to deliver anything from anywhere. What do you think of this startup? Leave a comment below if you have ever ordered from them.